21 seconds. This is going to be the best time in South Africa for many years. Wonderful.
And the winner is Samuel Sepeng.
First of all, let me take this opportunity to thank my wife, and also to take this opportunity, you know, to thank Caster Semenya, you know, for believing in me.
Caster's coach, Samuel Sepeng, Ezekiel Sepeng, we saw you slender, man. Back then, what year was that?
97, 96,
Ufufa.
Once upon the time,
huh? Ufufa, the Potchefstroom Express, Ezekiel Sepeng. Let me just give you a sense before we get to the conversation about the brother. But Ezekiel Sepeng, silver medal at the Olympic Games there in 1996. The only silver medal we got at that Olympics, right out of the apartheid years, coming into freedom. Ezekiel was at the front of that. Then he was like a silver medalist at the Commonwealth Games, silver medalist at the World Championships in 1990. This guy and the 800 meters, just, they were togetherness in those times. However, Ezekiel, let's maybe throw back and just understand the brotherly love that happens there back in those days. When you look back, what do you think? What do you remember about those days when you were doing it for the country out on the track?
Yeah, look, it was great. Not easy. It's funny that, you know, after 1996, everything that I was saying that I wanted to go to the Olympics because I've seen Olympics first time in 1992 with Ilana Meyer. And I just told my coach I also want to go. I thought it was the year after, you know, after 1993, because it's first time I
seen.
I didn't know it's 4 years. And I said to my coach, is it coming next year again? I'm going. And he says, no, no, you have to wait for 4 years. Then he said, it's 1996. I said, no, let's train for it. I want to go get the same medal as Ilana. Now, as I'm sitting here, I should have said, let me go and get a gold.
Yeah,
because I got this exactly the same, the silver like Ilana.
What was it like, Samuel, growing up in the household that had Ezekiel Sepeng, who back then was everything in South African terms?
Oh, you know, it was great because I remember those, you know, those years, even where we were staying. You know, most of the kids.
Kokai, tell
in
us.
In Achnar.
Kokai?
In Poch.
Poultry
farm is Boskop when you go to Carltonville.
It's outside, yeah.
Outside, you know, Poch.
Oh, GPS, you know. when it gets there.
So,
yeah?
You know, I remember after, you know, 96, like most of the kids, you know, where they were living that side, you know, most of them, they start doing sports. You know, every day morning they will go for their jogs and, you know, because of Zakes. You know, like most of them, like, it was a hero. And most of them, they say, yeah, I want to be like your brother. So they start training. And
even you did, because
I
you
did.
Also started, right?
I did, really. Even myself, I started.
Did you push it?
I started believing.
Ezekiel, did you push?
This time, I never thought he was going to run.
Sinas?
Oh, every time when we go, you know, when I go home during holidays, he'll join me. So the plan is we go about 10 kilometers. And it doesn't even last 1 kilo.
I just want to talk about Buruhumone. How did we work out Buruhumone? When was that fashion? We were South Africa also, Ezekiel's pants back in the day. But did you not think Samuel had the talent for it?
No,
or?
I didn't think. He was good in soccer.
You know,
he could be a striker, defender. Sometimes when we play, he'll also be a goalkeeper. So he was good in everything in soccer. But running-wise, I never thought. But when I decided to go back to Poch, then I joined his group with Jean Fester. I joined them and then I trained with them. That's why I saw at least he has improved. Yeah? So then I could see he was training with me, pacing me sometimes, and later, you know, he was beating me in training, so.
But you're only 31 now, right? What made it that you didn't become a world-class runner?
It's a tough one, because
the genes were there, Moss.
No, the genes were there, but, you know, I won't blame anyone. I won't blame the coach. I think the problem was me, because first, you need to believe. because, you know, running is individual sports. If I'm not strong enough, like the mental wise, because I can train good, but the upstairs, I'm not ready. You know, I don't believe on myself. Mm. I think the problem was I was scared because the training was good. It's only the matter of once we shift to the race, I'm always struggling. And, you know, the struggling was, I think it was me, you know, because...
Like that thing out choker, like, you know,
That
happens, Ezekiel?
Yeah, no, when we trained together, me and him, we always say he could have run 146 at least. But at the end, he ended up only running...
About 148.
148. And...
It sounds like nothing to the viewers. 2 seconds, yeah, that sounds like nothing. Marey, get this done. Yeah?
Yeah, but he was in training, he was good. Yeah, he choked every time he gets to the competition.
Oscar, he choked, man. He was choking.
No, he put it straight because if you check the training, before the race, I was like ready. Even training with Zeke, do everything with Zeke. You know, the times in training were good. You know, even... If you take the Europeans athlete, you know, watching us training, there was like this guy is a 145, you know, but that time I didn't have 145. I was like running 152 by that time.
152, yeah.
You know, but.
And Samuel, today you are the SA Sports Awards Coach of the Year. The year that you and Caster have had, what a season, what has been that secret? And what did you guys do? You're undefeated this year with Caster. How did you achieve that?
You know, first of all, obvious, if we look where we started, obvious, 2015. Because by that time I was like assistant coach, the guidance of Mr. Fester.
Caster's previous coach?
Yeah, yeah.
So you were there? And,
yeah, I was there. I was part of it.
Orulani Mole. Aha. Shapa assistant coach.
I was there. Yeah. I was there, you know, hitting the things. Obvious, for this year, you know, as a coach, you know, taking over, obvious, the target was, you know, taking over as a head coach. Knowing obviously the previous one, I'm part of it, the time like 2017, 16 backwards. But obviously as a coach taking over is, you know, come up with a mentality of, you know, want my own times because those ones not belong to me.
So you set new targets?
Yeah, that was my target of, even Caster knows, that was the target of, you know, we start from scratch.
Were you responsible for the different distances as well? Because Caster... over the last little bit now has been running 400s, 1500s, not just the 800s. Were you part of that thinking?
Yeah, we were part of it because it's a team. Obviously, it's not only about, you know, the decision of the coach.
So why? Why are we doing other things? No, that was
obvious. If you take the middle distance, once we talk about the middle distance, we start from 4 to 15. Mm. And obvious, Caster, come on, she's a 15, she's a middle distance runner. So she got speed, she got, you know, the
capability. She can do it all.
Yeah. So that's why we decided this year, you know what, we go for it.
The thing is, Waloy, Alwena. Because in March, I saw an article where you said, this year, Caster and I, as coach, can go undefeated. You predicted unpredictable. How?
No, it's not like predicting. It's knowing what we can do. Because if you take the previous years, obvious, 2016, before the season, the planning was, we go Olympic, we win that gold. You know, we go the Diamond League, we win the title of the Diamond League. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So, and I believe on myself. I believe on my work. You know, even Caster, I believe on Caster because, you know, she's a great person. She's a hard worker and, you know.
Is she difficult?
No, she's not.
Because three coaches, you know, she's gone through a couple of coaches already. There is that thing where maybe Caster's hard to work with. You're telling us no?
No. Firstly, the friendship, you know, understanding.
Linali chemistry.
Strong one. So that's what I'm saying for me is, you know, the friendship that we have in me and Caster. She talk, I talk. You understand? There's a time where we argue, but it's not like arguing is a fight. You know, we can argue now, laughing, get the conclusion, we're going to do this.
How important is a coach?
No, it's very important because it's as an athlete, you just need to focus on running. You need somebody that can plan for you all the sessions and be able to tell you when things are not perfect, your running style and look at your techniques and all those things.
Ezekiel, nowadays you are Athletic South Africa's excellence manager. You're dealing with those great athletes, making sure that they are achieving and getting to the levels that they want to. When we talk about the athlete that your brother is coaching, Caster Semenya, you are an 800 meter runner, one of the best we've ever had. Uh-huh. How good is Caster? And can she get better?
I think.
Can this coach make her even better?
You know, me and my brother, we talk. You know, I remember when we were in Nigeria, as you say, Waloy. He came to me and said, this is how it's going to go out in the 400. The first round, we're going to do 52. And as you can see,
he's talking about Caster. Here.
Caster. She always does with it with long tights. And they'll say, final, we go 50. And everything went exactly like that. And you know, I said after that, you know, Caster has done well this year. She's break the South African record from the 400 until the 1500. And I think she can still go faster. Yeah.
Marco shot the world record, coach.
Yeah, I wonder, Duan, with Thomas, we're working on it. Because obviously the target for us was, you know, testing 154.
Can she get to a world record?
She can. She can.
With this coach?
For sure.
We won't be going.
Really, I don't think she will change. You understand? Because the chemistry that we have in me and Caster, and we have long term now.
Guys, the Sepeng brothers, thank you. I loved it. Thank you for the conversation. Shampunaiza.
Thank you very much. People, South Africa, have brought Ben Mutuari straight from Orlando Pirates just for safety, just in case that Sundowns guy come get our trap sign. So just for safety, I brought him here. Dude, I need you to give a message to Bafana Bafana while I do the sign.
No, but stop doing that sign.
Okay.
Well, I wish the guys all the best, you know, make us proud, and hopefully you win the game.
There you go. Mara, that's sign.
Remi Tamadimu, Thomas.
The Sepeng brothers.